There are many important changes that have come out in Valorant patch 0.49, so let's break down the biggest ones that you need to know before ranked drops this competitive week. If you're a Valorant fan like I am, smash that subscribe button and let us know in the comments down below. But enough talking, let's just jump right into it, shall we? Now, there are two big characters that have gotten some fundamental changes in Omen and Sage. Let's first talk about Omen's changes. Now, the change in question is Omen's ultimate from the shadows. Now, let me talk about how the ultimate used to be and then talk about how it is now so that you really get to see the difference between what the change actually does. So before, it was you teleported as Omen, you were ethereal, which means you can't shoot anything, you're like this giant shade, and if you're killed, you get sent back to your spawn, no ultimate, you get no value, you wasted your ultimate. Then after that, you pop out and you're a different color, but you're invincible, so you can shoot enemies, but they can't shoot at you. And then you're actually in where you can get shot at and you can shoot them back. The problem with this is there was a weird time where you're like, oh, I want to kill him, I want to wait for him to pop out and teleport so I can punish him, but if I wait, then he's invincible and he can kill me. There was just a lot of really confusion. It was confusing. There was some bugs attached to this. So this is what it is now, and this is what it will be for the foreseeable future. You use your ultimate, you teleport in, you're still ethereal. If someone finds you and kills you, you get sent back. You don't actually die, you just get sent back and you lose your ultimate. So you gotta make sure not to teleport right on top of somebody. Now, once you teleport in, you're in. There's no invincibility, there's no different color. You go from being ethereal to being in the game, and then that's it. That's pretty much all the change. They basically completely skip the invincibility and the change color. It's a quality of life change. Overall, this actually nerfs Omen a fair bit because you lose out on this invincibility frames, but it's way more clear and concise for the average player, and that means that if you hear an Omen's teleport, you don't have to be afraid to push him, because sometimes you would hear it, you would push him, you'd get there right at the perfectly wrong time for him to just basically tank your shots and kill you, which is never fun. Now, this is a slight nerf. It's a pretty big nerf in Omen's category. So what they did is they changed this echo location to 2250. So basically, you have to be far closer to him to actually find or pinpoint where he teleported to. The idea is because he's a little bit weaker after the teleport, it makes it harder for you to find him. So the idea is even though he's easier to punish now after he teleports, it's a little bit harder for you to find him. So that adds a little sneak factor in the game. It makes him a little bit more sneaky of a character while nerfing one of the really annoying and complicated aspects of his ultimate, which I think is a good change overall. It's not going to dramatically change Omen's tier. It's not going to make him all of a sudden a top tier character. He's just going to be kind of a solo fragger the same way he has been, the same way that I listed him in my tier list. Now let's move on to the next change, which is from Sage. And there are some huge Sage changes that you need to know. So specifically, Sage's Barrier Orb has two changes. Let's talk about both of them and then I'll explain and break down what they mean for you. So the first one is Sage's wall will only completely spawn on solid ground. This means that some walls will only spawn one block or two blocks if it doesn't have a solid foundation. Now, the second thing is Barrier Orb can't be placed on a small piece of geometry. So this is specifically talking about those little pieces of geometry that you would stick your Sage wall to that would allow Omens and Jets to essentially go up above your wall and potentially make a snipe play or play on an enemy that couldn't even see them from crazy places. I mean, there was so many of them. I was actually working on a video about this and this got completely patched out pretty much. The majority of these got patched out, and while yes, I'm a little bit sad about that, it was really cool to be able to combo abilities in this way. A lot of these were broken. Frankly, they were just completely absurd. I mean, you would be floating basically in the air with your wall on a little tiny little thing that's peeking out from a wall, and you have a giant wall on top of it, and then you put a character on top of that, and you snipe someone all the way C-long that can't even see you. It was pretty broken, I'm not gonna lie, so I understand why they wanted to get it out of the game. Even though that they said that some will exist, the vast majority of them got completely patched out. Now, this is a big nerf, honestly, to Barrier Orb. So it's going to be a little bit less consistent where you need to have more solid foundation when you place your Sage Wall. And then, of course, you can't do the crazy cheeky things like Omens and Jets and going on top of the wall. So it's a pretty big nerf, but I don't think that it fundamentally changes Sage's team play. Her team aspect, where she's completely walling off a point, walling off a flank, or a potential push route, all these things are still there, so I don't really think that this changes her up or down on a tier list. She is still top tier. She's still insanely good, but it's important to know these changes if you're a Sage main or if you're up against Sage. You don't have to be looking out for all these crazy angles, and you need to be hyper aware of how you place your walls from now on as Sage, and you're not going to get some free value with comboing it with Omens and Jets. Now, as a bonus change that specifically has to do with Sage, but it's more about map geometry and map changes, the Haven double doors on defense had a really busted Sage peek spot. You could essentially wall yourself up and you could peek the very top crack of the door and only your head is showing. Barely your head is showing, but you could see enemies come through and pretty much get some free value and some free gills. Now they have added blinds, LOS blocking blinds, to basically make it so you could still peek it, but you can't see what's behind it. Now, you could definitely still combo this with something like a Sova's Recon Arrow. You find enemies, you see them, and then you can still shoot them through the blind. It still could be shot through very simply. It just blocks LOS, so it's not one-sided information, right? And enemies could still peek there and shoot you there if they think you're there. So it kind of adds a little bit of nuance to that spot. I really like how they balanced this because it doesn't just completely patch it out. They changed it and kind of brought it in line with a more fair and balanced for attack and defense. I mean, it so you couldn't really abuse this wall. So I think it's a great change overall. Now, let's talk about some other big quality of life things and things that you're going to want to know about ranked, about custom games, and about people leaving your games. But if you really hate people leaving your games, please smash that like button, because I know I do. Anyways, the first thing that they add is a ghost cheat mode in the custom games, which means you can fly around the map, you have infinite ammo, and it just allows you to explore the map and you don't have to play the game linearly. This is really great, especially for characters that have ability rollouts like Jett and Sova. It can really allow you to practice and hone your craft in learning all the different recon arrow spots and the different smoke spots. This is gonna be great for content creators and people that just wanna learn and grind the game. I love this change and I'm so glad they added it. And then on top of that, you can finally leave custom game matches. How many custom game matches have you started and you had to sit through the whole thing? If you left and you came back, you were put right back in the same game. Like, what? Why was this even here in the first place? Okay, I regress. I'm really happy that they've actually put this change in. Now you can join a custom game, you can play for a little while, and then after you figured out or tested whatever you wanted to test, you can leave, which is great. It's a great quality of life change. Now, here's a big change that I think everyone can get behind, and it's leavers and character dodgers will get a perpetually longer penalty the more often they do this. We don't quite know exactly how long that penalty will be, but you can imagine that it's exponentially more severe each and every time. This greatly disincentivizes people who just want to ruin all their games. They don't like it when you select their character, or they want to leave the second you start losing. Who doesn't love this change? The more people are disincentivized from leaving games, the better and higher quality our average games will be, which is very, very good for the vast majority of us who actually sit through and play through all of our games, which is great and fantastic. Now, the last thing that I gotta tell you is perhaps the most exciting news. Ranked mode will be 100% live for this patch. Let's go. Okay, so here is what you need to know about ranked mode. I've covered it in my ranked mode video, but let me just break down a few things that you need to do in your ranked games. First off, you need to be trying your best. No matter you're winning, no matter you're losing, try your best. You get a hidden MMR matchmaking system in the background that is performance based. So the better you do even when you're winning, the better you do when you're losing, the closer the games are, all that matters. So try your best every single game. Don't give up just because you're losing. Try to kill as many people as you can. Stomp the enemy if you have an advantage. All these things extremely, extremely matter. So that will give you the best shot at performing well at ranked. On top of that, if you want to ensure that you're going to pop off in ranked and that you know every single ounce of knowledge that will help you perform and climb straight to that Valorant rank, smash that subscribe button. We're pumping out double daily uploads, so jump right in. Anyways, I hope this guide has been helpful for you. I know I didn't include every change, but I really wanted to talk about the very specific ones that I think really matter to the average player. Now, if you want to read the full patch notes, we're going to include a link down below straight to the Riot patch notes so you can read every single change just for yourself. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or you just want to roast me, do it down below, please. But I think that's all we got for you today. I'm Coach Mills. And until next time.